ta'ala, it's a big deal. It's a big deal. Even if it's any kind, a kind of indirect kind of accusation or indirect word. You don't intend to say that, but it happened to be one of those words, one of those looks, you know? One of those, you know, moment that you shouldn't listen to this conversation, you shouldn't add to this conversation, you shouldn't take part in this conversation, you shouldn't take from this money, you shouldn't give this money, you shouldn't do this, you shouldn't do that. But because you don't understand or you underestimate the consequences of doing this kind of action, you will find yourself in the end in a trouble, in a lot of trouble with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this call all comes under this category. This amazing ayah. This is the scariest ayah in the Quran. If you listen, if you look at this ayah carefully, this ayah should shake us from the roots. We should be shaken from the roots. It should shake our hearts. And it did actually happen, it did do that with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He himself was so much concerned about this ayah. In the end of Surah Al-Zalzala, two ayahs, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ مِثْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ خَيْرًا يَرَى وَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ مِثْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ شَرًّا يَرَى. It gives extremely big hope, and at the same time, it gives extremely, you know, big concern. It put us in a situation that we are extremely hopeful and extremely desperate. Extremely hopeful because Allah said, no matter how little the good deed you do, even if it's invisible, very subtle, very delicate, as tiny as a mustard seed or even smaller, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will still reward you. Not according to the size of your good deed, but according to the size of Allah's bounty and blessings. Subhanallah. And on the other side, وَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ مِثْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ شَرًّا يَرَى. And whosoever does a little tiny amount of bad deed, of evil, as small as a mustard seed or less than that, he will still see the consequences of this evil, of this bad deed. He will see it in the record. It will be recorded, it will be documented, and it will be definitely presented to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if Allah wants, he will be questioned and he will be asked about that. Subhanallah. This ayah will actually put us on the right track. Wa alaykum as-salam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. If you consider this ayah, فَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ مِثْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ خَيْرًا يَرَى وَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ مِثْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ شَرًّا يَرَى وَ عَلَيْكُمْ السَّلَامُ وَرَحْمَةُ وَبَرَكَاتُهُ. You will find yourself in a situation that you are not able to ignore the presence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in your life. Brothers and elders, as I said before in the beginning of my speech, that we as people, as normal people, average Muslim, I don't claim to be a super hero Muslim, or I don't claim about myself extra merit. Not because I'm sitting here, I'm talking to you. I might have some extra knowledge, but it doesn't mean that I'm very close to Allah, closer than any one of you, or better than any one of you. All of us as average people, average Muslim, we actually have things in our life we think they are not big deal, but for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala they are big deeds. And we think that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wouldn't mind us doing these kind of things, he wouldn't care much about them. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala could hold us accountable for these, and we could be ruined, we could be in trouble because of these small little tiny things. As I said earlier, that this ayah gives us extreme hope and at the same time gives us extreme despair. So how should I balance between them? How should I do my, should I just punish myself, torture myself every day, and every day cry all the night, all the time because of things that I may have done? What should I do as a Muslim? Yes, I know that I do things that I look at them as insignificant. I might not be aware of them. And if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will hold me accountable for all of these things, then I'm lost. Definitely I'm lost. Why? Because many of these things, we don't even think about them. Unthinkable. They just happen. We just joke, flick a joke here, say a word here, look here. You know, just things like that happen. No way. You can't avoid them. No way. And I believe that no one can show hand and say, no, brother, wallahi, I don't do any of these things. Don't show hands. I know some cowboys are here all the time, they will show hands. Yes, I don't do that. Okay, I don't. Okay, keep it for yourself. Nobody can claim that they don't do that. Now, what is the solution? What can I do? Well, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala opened a door for us for two types of cleaning. Intentional cleaning and automated cleaning. You know, for the people who have a lot of money, not me of course, they buy certain type of stoves, right? Self-cleaning. So you do all the cooking, all the graving, and you do a lot of mess in the stove, and you know, in the oven. And you know, this is one of the hardest jobs at home. If your wife said, okay, come and clean the oven for me, you will run away. You will call the doctor and say, oh, no, I'm sick, I can't do that. Find a way out. This is one of the toughest jobs at home, to clean the oven, especially for those people who are meat lovers, cook a lot of meat there. Those stoves, they are self-cleaning. They clean themselves automatically. All what you need to do, just press a button, relax, and they will do the job, right? And some others need scrubbing and, you know, washing and, you know, certain chemicals, really very hard job. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us certain type of cleaning. One of them is automated cleaning. This automated cleaning sounds to be very simple and easy, but they are amazing. They are really amazing. Rasulullah s.a.w. give us different type of automated cleaners, automated cleanup materials that we can use. Whatever is convenient to you, just do it. Whatever is convenient to do, you just do it. And you will have to be certain that any of these cleaners is good enough to wipe out all of these actions or minor sins that might have occurred or might happen without your knowledge, or you just don't know about them. They just happened, unintentionally happened. Like the five daily prayers, alhamdulillah, and one of the things Rasulullah said, "Man qala astaghfirullah al-azim wa atubu ilayh fi al-yawm 100 marra." Astaghfirullah al-azim wa atubu ilayh fi al-yawm 100 marra. Ghufrat dhunubu wa in kanat mithla zabad al-bahr. His sins will be wiped out, even if they are as big as the foam on the surface of the ocean. Subhanallah. How many of us get the time to do that? I mean, most of the people, to be honest, are so rushed, they can't have the time to do just little things. Few minutes, 3-4 minutes, good enough. Subhanallah. Astaghfirullah al-azim wa atubu ilayh fi al-yawm 100 marra. Rasulullah s.a.w. said, man qala, Allahumma anta rabbi, la ilaha illa ant, khalaqtani wa ana abduk, wa ana ala ahdika wa wa'adika ma istata'at. أعوذ بك من شر ما صنعت أبوء لك بنعمتك علي وأبوء بذنبي فاغفر لي فإنه لا يغفر الذنوب إلا أنت. This is a very well known dua. You will find it in any dua app or anything, which is known as dua al-tawbah. This is the dua for repentance. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, all of his sins will be wiped out, even if he has run away from the battlefield. Like if he has done, you know, major, great, destructive sins, all will be deleted, right? These and so many other practices are good enough to wipe out these little things that we are not aware of them. So when we meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we'll find our record clean. Because the thing that we don't actually remember all the time, but it is happening all the time, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the surah I have recited, كَلَّا بَلْ تُكَذِّبُونَ بِالدِّينِ وَإِنَّ عَلَيْكُمْ لَحَافِظِينَ كِرَامًا كَاتِبِينَ. You have people safeguarding recorders. They are recording everything in writing. They are recording everything in writing. كِرَامًا كَاتِبِينَ يَعْلَمُونَ مَا تَفْعَلُونَ. They know what you do in such a way that even if you have no intention to do them, they will write your action, you know, coupled with the intention. Just listen carefully. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, those angels are so smart, so professional, that they write down your deeds, and these deeds coupled with your intentions. I might see you do something, but I don't know what is your intention. You might see me doing something, but I don't know, you don't know my intention. But the angels will be able to figure out this action and the intention that comes with this action. Al-amal wal-niyya. This is the meaning of the word yaf'alun. يَعْلَمُونَ مَا تَفْعَلُونَ تَفْعَلُونَ something that you determine to do it with intention. And this pre-intended act of good deeds or bad deeds will be recorded that way with the angels, by the angels. SubhanAllah. And that is why the ayah that comes after that, كَلَّا بَلْ تُكَذِّبُونَ بِالدِّينَ, that is the day of deen. What is deen? Is to pay people something that you borrow. Or the people pay you back something that they borrow from you. It's just a time of like balancing. You clear the balance. Whatever I borrowed from you, whatever you borrowed from me, we just clear the fund. And this fund comes in dollars and in cents as well. Like in other words, very detailed. You have to do that. On the day of Qiyamah, Yawmuddin, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will clear the balance.